Unconsciously repeating the following habits might be the silent killers of your likability. So, in the next few minutes, I'll make you aware of 4 things you habitually do that make you less likable and tell you what to do instead to be more likable. My name is Yash. My goal is to help you level up in life and become a better version of yourself. If that sounds interesting to you, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Without wasting any time, let's get started. Sometimes likability is about shutting up and listening, instead of sharing your own 2 cents on any given topic. Most people are afraid of saying, "I don't know," because they think it's a weakness. The reality is that you can't know everything, and admitting that you're not the best at everything is a sign of intelligence, because it allows you to save your resources. You can't be an expert on any topic, and you don't need to have an opinion on everything. This pandemic showed us a great example of how people often try to put their opinions over facts and data. I constantly hear people saying things like, "I believe the government is making wrong decisions," or "I don't think the vaccine is safe." The truth is that sometimes your opinion doesn't matter, and it's better to save your time, energy, and effort for things you can actually influence. Certain discussions require opinions. Others require competence, expertise, facts, and data. You can't be great at everything, so don't try to pretend it. Allow experts to shine on stage if it's their turn, and focus on the things you are actually good at. We like people we can trust. Being punctual is one of the simplest yet most underrated ways to build that trust. If someone can't even make it on time to a meeting, how can I trust that they'll manage to keep other more essential promises? Our time is one of our most precious resources, and being late indicates that you don't value the time of others. Unexpected situations can happen to all of us, but whenever you have the choice, you'll be better off when you're 15 minutes early instead of 5 minutes late. The famous businessman Henry Ford once stated that you can't build a reputation on what you are going to do. Yet, that's exactly what most people try. They talk about things but never do them. They promise their partner to be more understanding and caring, but fail to make time for a date night. They talk about one business idea after the other, but never launch a solid product or service. They talk about losing weight, but end up ordering a giant pizza with extra cheese and Diet Coke. Talking is easy, doing is hard. But the problem is that constantly listening to someone who's talking about the next big thing without ever lifting a finger is exhausting too. Sharing your ideas and ambitions to receive feedback and encouragement is great, but don't overdo it. Sometimes it's better to keep your enthusiasm to yourself and share the things you actually do after taking action. Most people enjoy listening to a true success story, but we all hate bragging. Yet, many people don't understand the difference between being proud of yourself and being annoying. And the reality is that most people don't care much about you, they care about themselves. So in most of your conversations, you'll be better off if you ask your conversation partner about their wins and struggles instead of showcasing all your medals. Sure, a conversation should always be two-sided, and of course, you can share your experiences, including your success stories. Yet, the most pleasant conversations happen when our conversation partner is relatable instead of out of touch. If you want to be more relatable, ask more questions, Be humble about your achievements and let people feel that you genuinely care about them. Don't turn every conversation into a presentation about yourself, but focus on the two-sided relationship and the value you can provide for your conversation partner. You can make more friends in 2 months by becoming interested in other people than you can in 2 years by trying to get other people interested in you. Trying to be more likable is not about faking your personality, but about minimizing the silent killers, so you can better connect with those around you and build genuinely valuable relationships. Our entire lives are based on humane connections, so it pays off to be a better, more caring conversation partner, parent, colleague, or friend. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe and watch some of my other recent videos as well. And let's level up together!